Like the rest of the world, China's education system increasingly turned to digital solutions during the COVID-19 pandemic. Among those to benefit from the shifting of classrooms to online settings are edtech companies, which have been gaining in popularity in recent years, even before the pandemic's effect. The variety of educational tools and services on offer have been popular with parents wanting to give their kids as much of an advantage as possible before they face the National College Entrance Exam. Investors have also taken notice of the sector in the country. According to Holon IQ, investment in edtech in China reached $10.2 billion in 2020. In this video, we take a look at the top 5 Chinese edtech unicorns by valuation, based on Holon IQ's January 2021 EdTech Unicorns list. Yuanfudao was founded in 2012 and offers a range of digital learning products which cover things like live tutoring, AI-powered learning, and homework helping tools aimed at primary and secondary school students. The company also employs over 30,000 workers in teacher centers all over China. According to a 36KR report, the company generated $1.53 billion in total revenue in 2020, becoming the highest-grossing competitor in the online education sector in China. And according to Yuanfudao, about 4 million students use their paid courses. In March of 2020, they received $1 billion in the then-largest ever edtech fundraising deal in China. Founded in 2014, Zuoyabang offers K-12 online services and is a direct competitor to Yuanfudao. Its AI-powered Zuoyabang Super App can help answer questions and includes learning exercises, live stream courses, and has assignment grading capabilities. They even offer smart hardware, including a printer which can detect mistakes made by students. 70% of students in China use Zuoyabang, and in 2019 and 2020, it was the only online education provider to surpass 100 million monthly active users. At the end of 2020, the firm landed a $1.6 billion investment. VIP Kid was founded in 2013. And is primarily known for connecting children in China with English teachers from North America through their online platform, where a key feature is one-on-one video tutoring. According to VIP Kid, they had over 100,000 teachers and 800,000 students on the platform by October of 2020. In early 2020, VIP Kid's sub-brand Dami Wangxiao, which offers live streaming math and English courses, completed a Series A funding round for $80 million, led by Tencent and Sequoia Capital. Founded in 2005, Zhangmen initially focused on offline after-school training courses. In 2014, after raising an undisclosed amount in an angel round from Qingsong Fund, the firm began to offer online courses. They have an app catered toward K-12 students to receive one-on-one tutoring from subjects ranging from English to math online, and have over 40 million users based in over 600 cities across China. In October of 2020, Zhangmen received $400 million in a funding round from investors, most notably SoftBank. Set up in 2014, Nobox offers online test banks to students, parents, and teachers, and exercises tailored to students through its apps. In 2019, the startup closed a Series D round with $150 million from Alibaba. But it hasn't been smooth sailing, as the firm reportedly faced difficulties in monetizing its business model, and by the end of 2019, faced the prospect of laying off 40% of its workforce. So can online education firms continue to sustain as well as grow their user base? The general trend since 2017 has seen increasing online education users year after year, and the further integration of online and offline classroom solutions could see the edtech sector play an increasingly important role.